Yes, what time is it? I don't know what time it is, but we are live.
3:46.
We are live. Hello, Facebook, YouTube, tribe. It is a beautiful afternoon. We are here at Hollywood, California, Griffith Park. JacQuel here from Ancient Light Insights. And I have a great guest today here with me, a fellow YouTuber. He is a fellow YouTuber who connected with me in YouTube. His name is ablaze, and he talks a lot about astrology, esoteric, just all spirituality. And we found each other and we've been supporting each other on YouTube. And he just happened to be here because his family live around. And he just hit me up, hey, I'd love to visit you. I have a book that I want to share with you. And here we are at Griffith Park with ablaze, amazing person. We were just chatting about so many things, astrology and spirituality, how, you know, just our high vibes, because it's all about, what is it?
It's all about positive vibes. You know the vibes, PVO, positive vibes only, FOE, family over everything, high vibrations. Hope everybody's staying focused,
yes,
staying balanced, shooting all negativity down, protecting your energy, focusing on yourself, and mastering self.
That's right. And that is his intro in his channel. I will be putting a link to his channel on YouTube as well as mine, so that you can subscribe to his channel, check out his content. He's making a difference out there and really putting information out there. So check him out. We're here together right now. We're about to blaze because we're celebrating this beautiful weekend. You know, it's like midsummer. Midsummer. This is midsummer right now, summer solstice, which means it's the longest day of the year is coming up, the shortest night. We're going to celebrate abundance, the pleasures of life, the sun, the shining, everything. So come in with open heart, open mind, and just enjoy this with us, this gathering here with my new friend, ablaze. And we're blazing, so if you want to blaze with us, blazing organic flower. It's not something that, you know, we do it recreationally just to share as part of a medicine that grows in the herb. It doesn't have any chemicals or anything. We do it responsibly. We should do it because it resonates with us, not for everyone. But we're just sharing that part of abundance, a medicine that grows out of the earth and is part of midsummer celebration to celebrate foods, pleasures that we eat, the beauty of life, and the things that grow out of the earth. So with that being said, hello Peter, everyone tuning in. Ashe to la medicina, to the medicine. Thank you so much, ablaze, for sharing your medicine. And we're smoking this out of a beautiful leaf. It's very delicate.
What? Yeah, it was
hitting. That's always my hit. And just come in, and we're going to share this. This is a live from Facebook right now, but this will be shared on both of our YouTube channels. So this is for all of my YouTubers and my Facebook followers and my friends and my beloved people. As the sun begins to rise and thinks about you, Rick from New Zealand, sending you a big hug. I'm so glad that you're here with us.
Shout out to New Zealand.
Shout out to New Zealand. I might move. This is one of the places that I've been trying to move. Rick, my friend over here on Facebook, we've been talking about New Zealand. It's a good spot. He changed his life there. Thank you for being here.
Shout out to Rick in New Zealand.
Shout out to you from ablaze and JacQuel. And once you come in, leave a message. Say greetings. Say hi. Don't ghost. Just let yourself known so that we can bless all the people coming in, and say hello so I can see, because sometimes the comments won't come in. But either way, we're just going to share a little bit on the topics that we touch on, the stuff that we're learning that we share on our YouTube platforms, which is astrology, spirituality, esoteric, secretism, just life in general, deep stuff. And yeah, so just come in with an open heart, an open mind, and take in what resonates and let the rest dissipate like smoke.
Well, like JacQuel was saying, I'm here visiting Los Angeles, California. I have family here. And so it's a beautiful, nice summer day. You know, the sun is out. Everyone's out just vibing in nature. Just trying to get that good energy. And, you know, just trying to enjoy this physical experience that we're in. You know, COVID kicked all our ass.
Exactly. He's so right. Like, as we all know at this point, you know, a whole full year after COVID, and the life has shaken us, is taking everything to different directions, and it's part of evolving, it's part of the shift. The clock turns from 9 to 10. So to be in acceptance of that, what it is, versus complaining. And you know, that's why we prepare in life for the winter and the cold nights. We prepare, right? We prepare because we know that inevitably the cold weather, the winter is coming. So we prepare for the cold. We don't just, you know, we prepare the coats. We take them out in fall and autumn. We don't just have our bathing suit in winter. We prepare for these things. Same with life and with the challenges and everything. And to enjoy the present moment like this with people, other people who support you. Like, I mean, this guy is amazing in his channel. And when he told me he's gonna be here, he hit me up. I appreciate that. Because it just shows that, you know, he really appreciates my content genuinely. And I do the same, so I was like, oh, of course we're gonna meet. Are you kidding me? We're gonna go live too and do a video together. You have a lot of positive things to say. Yeah,
I was so excited to meet her. I got it. It's another YouTuber, my boy, Virgo King.
Shout out to Virgo King.
Y'all go check him out, Virgo King. He actually put me on to JacQuel, and he was just saying, man, you got to check this sister out. She has amazing content on her channel, and she's on that frequency that we're on. I was like, really? I checked her out, subscribed, and I watched probably all your videos.
You did.
I probably watched all your videos. I comment on all your videos.
Thank you.
But most importantly, I just admired all the content that was on there. I can tell that you were like, you know, maybe on the same journey as me, or just a couple levels up. And I had to meet you, you know, pick at your brain a little bit.
Yeah, I like that.
And learn as well. Because that's what, you know, that's what this physical experience is about.
Thank you.
It's about learning.
And likewise, like even myself, like, you know, I have my teachers, I have what I call kind of students. And I learn, we all learn from each other, whether it's teachers or students. We learn things from each other. I'm learning a lot from him as well. He's in the beginning stage of this whole, you know, this life of, you know, when we evolve the higher planes, basically. It's like going up, when you go to from middle school to high school, you're like, oh my God, I'm in high school. And you're getting used to this. So, and he's, I love how open-minded and receptive you are about the things. Like, most people don't even care to dive deep in these things. And you add it. And also, I notice how you really watch my whole video, not like halfway through, so you really pick up on the message and you get comments. And that is something very important to do when we support each other. Actually take the time to look at the content of the full content, because the message is only there when you look at the whole thing. Even if it's an hour, you can always stop and continue later. It's YouTube.
It might be a 45 minute video, and you know, if you only watch, you know, the first 7-8 minutes of it, you could miss something critical to you that might have been directed towards you, like maybe like the 18 minute mark of the video or something.
Exactly, yeah, and like every little thing, and you never know. For me, like, you can miss something important, but it's up to you. Nevertheless, how beautiful it is to connect from with the internet. The beauty about Aquarian age, is how humanity and the universe is evolving. To like technology, there's so much things, computers, we can communicate from across the world. By the way, we never mentioned where you're from. Anyway, Virgo King, I'm going to post his channel also, so that you can subscribe to the brother, because if he was here, he would have been here with us right now.
Yes.
he would be next to me, I would be in the middle.
Yes.
And I can't wait to meet him too one day.
Maryland in the house.
Maryland. These men are from Maryland. So shout out to Maryland.
Shout out to Maryland.
He's here in LA. And yeah, the Aquarian Age, so we have technology. Like, we just met. He's in Maryland. I'm here. You know, we support each other. We're raising our vibrational frequency, actually learning. It's not like just dumb friendship, you know, like the dumb friendship stage. This is like we're elevating and helping each other, growing a community, a tribe.
Networking.
And here we are. I'm so glad to have met you.
Networking building. Networking building. That's what it's about.
It's what it's about.
Connecting. Connecting, networking, building. I like to be around, you know, like-minded individuals nowadays in my journey, honestly. So that was one of the main reasons on reaching out to you and letting you know that I was going to be here visiting, you know, your state, as well as, you know, me having family and friends here, too.
Oh, that's so great. And it was really interesting because I shouldn't have not been here. As you guys know, I've been trying to move for a long time, and this has dragged because the universe is saying not yet. We're just finishing up closing contracts, so on and so forth. And when he told me he's gonna be here by June, it was like 2 months ago. Yeah. I said, I'm gonna be gone most likely. And he's like, oh wow, like he had this book that he was gonna mail that. He's like, I wanted to give it to you in person. And I'm like, we'll see what happens. And hey, here I am, still here. This happened. It's called synchronicity, not coincidence. Exactly. It's a beautiful thing, the connection, the networking, you know. And that's the Virgo in both of us, by the way. He's a Virgo.
Shout out to my Virgos.
Virgo out there. Virgo, sun, and ascendant. Both. So he's the Virgo king, too. Virgo king, he's the Virgo king, too. And I am a Virgo, Libra ascendant. And it's ruled by Mercury. The planet Mercury is all air, communication, intelligence, information, the connector. So we that's what we do, communication. Very intelligent, and it can get us in the head too much too.
Yeah.
So, you know, we ground ourselves in different things like this.
Yeah, exactly. And like I said, I just like to network and build with like-minded individuals as I'm going through my journey. I was actually April 10th, I had took a trip down to Miami, Florida.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was...
That's interesting.
Yeah, it's a YouTuber. Shout out to Sean G. He's a YouTuber that he do like calisthenics, workouts, and a lot of like motivational entrepreneurship content over there on his channel.
Sean G, shout out to you.
And he had a conference, an entrepreneurship, leadership, motivational conference. And it was actually, it was a lot of YouTubers that was there.
Wow.
Shout out to Papa Duck.
Papa
Duck. It's a couple. Nino Brown. There was a lot of
Nino
YouTubers
Brown
that was there. Wallow67.
Wallow67.
Yeah, a lot of YouTubers was there, and like I said, my whole reason for going there was just to network and build, you know, with like-minded individuals. I'm not gonna say everybody was maybe on you know, that spirituality frequency.
Yes.
But they still was on, you know, motivational.
Yeah, like positive
leadership
people.
And entrepreneurship.
And that's great. And that's part of, like, sometimes that's what it is earthy people who have a lot of earth in their charts. So they are really good with making money, and they have that drive, maybe Mars energy, to make money. But they might not be that spiritual, but still, it's better than, you know, being bum in the streets and just not want to do anything for yourself. They're just, it's a matter of connecting. Now they connect with someone like you, for instance, get to know each other, and all of a sudden he can introduce something that can maybe inspire something in this person, and vice versa.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing. Like, we help each other, we build each other, we're a community, we're like ants. Human beings are like ants.
Yeah.
Like, we are. We live in community, we build each other. Yes, we can survive, one can survive, and independence is number one. But we live in community. It is what it is. To be stronger is to have a community to be more stronger. Ancestors, shamans, like the lineage. Combine our lineage and you create a lot of spiritual guides around you, protecting you and even helping more. It's real.
You have to want to do it, and then you have to do it. And when I say that, meaning like with anything in life, with the whole experience, with you going after anything that you want to do. You have to want to do it, and then you have to actually do it. Like, I want to build with like-minded individuals. I want to learn more about myself. I want to be, you know, on the road to success. So I gotta put myself in that position. And one of the, you know, things that I did was go to that entrepreneurship conference. Or, you know, when I'm coming out of California to visit the family and friends, reaching out to you because of, you know, the type of journey that you're on and the type of knowledge that I can gain from you through our encounters.
And this is so important. I swear that what you just mentioned is like the difference between like talking shit and making shit happen, basically. Because at the end of the day, it's your willpower, your Atta chakra, okay? Your third chakra, the fire element within the hatha. Like when you're in martial arts, this is the core. But it comes, the willpower comes from there. So we can plan a whole castles of sand in our mind, but to make it happen is very earthy too. Because earth elements, Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo, we create abundance from the earth. And then fire elements are, you know, they spark that energy just to make it happen. So it all comes with action. I always tell people, and this is something that all my friends can say that I drill them about, but when they talk, I'm like, don't talk shit to me, show me with actions. I was like, always tell people, don't tell me, you know what, if I don't see results, your actions, what you, the way you can tell, you can never say that you love me ever, and yet I can feel that you do, that, you know what I mean, like you can just, your actions show everything. I can tell someone I don't love you ever. It's like, wow, this person loves me so much because they prove it. That sometimes words are empty too. A lot of people talk a lot, too much. Override. Too much air. The mercurial energy that I'm talking about when it's out of balance. Then now you can be over talking and gossiping and just over talking, interrupting people when they're speaking. And making things up.
Not even listening to, not even to listening. What you're saying, what's coming out their mouth. So they can't.
And which is part of communication. Listening is part of communication, to be quiet and listen to people. So controlling that, very earthy, is very earthy element. That's a little deep.
Good vibes.
Let that sink in.
Let that sink in.
For a minute while we hit a split real quick. Wait.
Yeah. But yeah, just anything that you all want out there in life, just do it. Like, regardless, if
anything,
if it's a, you know what I mean, a long term goal, a short term goal, if it's, you know, something to this day, something to that day, just know that you manifest whatever you want. You are the creator of your reality.
I'm with you, mi amor, Rajin. Oh my God, my brother, Rajin. I send you a big hug. I love you. This is for years, my friend. This is the Ablaze. So all of you coming in, again, I'll mention a fellow YouTuber. Somehow we cross together on our YouTube channels because we share same content, you know, elevating all that. And he started supporting me. I started supporting him. And we just, it's Virgo King too, us three. And he's from Maryland. His parents or family here, he just came to visit and he said, I want to meet you, I have a book for you. He shared with me. Did I bring the book so I can show people? Oh, I didn't bring the book. I will do another video with the book. So we might read it, and I might do a lecture. I've been thinking of doing a YouTube lecture with important books that I need to read. I need to read that one and Ken Keir's book also. So welcome in. We're doing this live because we're here connecting. We met now. And from here, we're only networking and creating something grand. But, you know, the plan of independence and, you know, waking up to a higher you. That's the higher self.
Waking up to your higher self.
The higher self.
Unlocking knowledge that one already knows. What I truly believe, we're just, you know, remembering the knowledge. So when we bump into these encounters, these different people, we come across the, you know, the knowledge that sparks it. It's just
you know, you say that and it's actually true.
Yeah.
In fact, it's incredible. It's like innately you know these things. It's true because we make a contract before we come here. We just want to feel the pleasures. We're spiritual beings. It's beautiful. Androgynous. Just like no sex. We're just like this beautiful spirit in heaven. And we do this contract. We want to come as a man, as a woman, and experience, oh yeah, pleasure and living. But it comes with consequences as everything.
It does.
It's just what it is. It's cause and effect. You know, this the polarity is a beautiful thing. Mm-hmm. And this is where my Libra, I'm a Virgo Libra cusp, actually. So, and it comes out because everything I talk about balance so much is a big thing that I speak about, authenticity and balance. The polarities, when you respect the polarities and understand about the sun and the earth energy, of those, the masculine and feminine force, and to be in the middle of them, and you know, accept, like for instance, you're a man, but you have feminine energy. I'm, and it's okay to keep in balance both. Because even being, for a woman, very feminine, as beautiful as it looks, but if you're extremely vulnerable to the point that you wouldn't sit here and get your hands dirty, or climb a mountain or something, because you're gonna scratch your skin, then you, no, seriously, it's too much feminine and the masculine is depressed.
Right.
So when you see these powerful women who like kick ass, do their yoga, you know, when they have this physical ability and you see it in their physicality, it's that balance. They embrace the masculine within. Same with the men that are just, ah, fuck, I'm not gonna cry, I'm this tough boy, that overly, you're just over in the masculine and you don't embrace, you can't cry, that the feminine within you is being suppressed. It's the poor feminine in you that you have, whether you accept it or not, we all have. It's the feminine force that allows you to be sensitive, be intuitive, you know? Think more like outside the box. Beautify things in your life. It's what makes people sensual and sexy. It's that feminine energy. So it's okay for a man to be sensitive. It's beautiful, in fact. It's part of that balance.
It definitely is.
Balance.
Balance is key.
Balance is key. And we work with these energies. We work with them, you know, constantly.
The yin and the yang.
It's a beautiful thing. The yin and the yang. We have that force within us. My friends, can you... Is it dark or what? I hope you guys are seeing me. Am I on?
I think they can see you. Yeah,
yeah, it just became dark because I have to touch it here. I see. Rajin is saying something. I'm sorry, my loves. I don't mention your name and you're my beloved friend, the yin in me, yeah, the balance. Oh, Rajin. His name is Rajin. It's like the yin yang.
Yeah.
You will love my brother. Oh my God. You guys will love each other. Yeah, it's good vibes. Like, he actually lives in Florida, so we can connect. Yeah, that to me is really important in life. It helps you to be able to swing from your feminine to your masculine, whatever you need. So it's like if you're feeling in the lumps and very depressed, like, oh, you don't want to, you need to empower your male energy, fire element.
So you mentioned about like the guys that are overly aggressive or all like as far as like too much in the masculine. So how does one like, you know, find that balance?
So to be in tune with nature, basically, and it's to surrender a lot. Like I was just gonna say, it's a very good question. Like, let's say that you feel in the lumps and very depressed. And some people are like, you can't pick them up. They're very into their depressed feminine energy. Because feminine energy is negative energy. It's like the positive and the masculine. It creates a conductor in the wall. There's a positive and the negative. Same thing. And it creates energy. So create a child, you know, essentially. The polarities are important. But they're like opposite, but they attract each other in the same form. So it means that you need to raise your masculine energy. So how can you do that? You can get out in the sun for once to build in, you know, serotonin. It's stimulated by the sun, sulfate of vitamin D that you can't get from a pill. It lifts your spirits up naturally. It stimulates Serotonin is the happy hormone we have naturally. Melatonin is the one that you receive to go to sleep. It helps you to relax and sleep deep. Melatonin. You can do it by fire gazing at night. So that's a good way to do it. Get out into nature. Wear some citrine, some yellow calcite, amber, tiger's eye, crystals. Very empowering. Connected to the solar energy that can help. Exercise, fire, right? The fire. Oh my gosh. it's dying my battery. So either way, that's what we do. And if we're too on the male, and we're just too aggressive, we find ourselves aggressive, hitting people, being nasty, you need to get in touch with your feminine. Get in a bathtub, go swimming, water is element, energy, it cleanses you, it relaxes you. Use amethyst, you know, green adventuring, soft crystals, rose quartz to relax you. And then you just connect with the night. Go out on a walk at night, safely, of course. And that helps to bring up the feminine, and you can do balance there. Oh my gosh, I hate to stop this. I'm gonna try to see if I can do it on another phone, but my battery is dying and we are in a park. Maybe we can go, I don't know, maybe finish this somehow, somewhere. We'll see. Yeah, but I want to, before it cuts off, please check out, I'm going to post all of our links. We might do, who knows, this will happen more often somehow.
Definitely will.
Either way, I want to let the ablaze close this with a few words of insights for all of us.
Y'all stay focused out there. Y'all stay balanced. Don't ever give up on yourself. Know that you're great. You can do anything you put your mind to it. You're the creator of your reality. Don't let no one tell you that you can't. Mm. Always keep going. Mm. And try to look at things in always in a positive manner. Even through the negativity, always try to find the positive. It's always positive and negative.
It's beautiful. That's so true. Amen. Thy will be done to that. And the sun, the day, the 21st, please get out. And be grateful to the sun, the light that gives us life, and all this food that we have grown. And it's the longest day, knowing that winter's coming anytime soon. We'll be already cold, dead, everything comes. So prepare for that and be grateful so you're protected during those dark times. It's in sync with the universe, it's in sync with the elements, with the animal kingdoms that protects you. You know, you're in tune with the circadian rhythms. So we will leave this at that. We love you so much. And till the next one. Namaste.